So good morning, my name is Xavier Melcognon. I am in charge of CATIA Design R&D in Dassault Systèmes. And today I will talk about an industry solution called Integrated Heavy Machinery from Dassault Systèmes that is done and led by Dominique Calmel, which is the director of the Industry Solution for Industrial Equipment. So as I said, I work for Dassault Systèmes. Our purpose and belief is to create virtual world to help you to extend and improve the real world. Today at Dassault Systèmes, we are more than 20,000 people worldwide. We are operating in multiple countries. We are a scientific company with a lot of R&D labs. And we have three headquarters, with the worldwide one in Dassault Systèmes in Paris. We are roughly doing 4.5 billion euro revenue with 290,000 customers. We are celebrating our 40th anniversary this year. We have started by delivering 3D design, then digital mock-up, to move to product lifecycle management, and then the experience economy with the 3D experience platform, moving now to the virtual twin experience, integrating human at the center of our design. We do that to serve 11 industries with solutions, including the industrial equipment industry, to address your business processes with brands, roles, and apps. We have some famous and historical brands such as CATIA, SolidWorks, Dalmia, Simulia, but we have in total 12 brands serving these industry processes. So for today, we'll talk about industrial equipment, and I will focus more on a specific industry solution called heavy machinery equipment with an example called the B project. So to make our solutions, we want to make sure we address your challenges. And there are four ones that, in addition to what I said, your drivers, which are very important, is the global solution that you need to provide, not just the point product, the point solution, but more global offering, to address, as I said, the sustainability trend, to make sure your products are following the right regulations and safety, and to have the right operation performance for you, but more important for your customers. Okay, so this is what I will try to show you with the solution we offer to address all these challenges with this integrated heavy machinery solution. So with our solution, what we want to do on the 3D experience platform is to make sure we have a full digital continuity offering solution for you on a single platform to break all the silos between the different departments to leverage the social innovation. From requirement and upstream thinking to design, engineering, system engineering, to simulation and conformity, manufacturing, sales and marketing, operation and ownership. So today I will not focus on all these value stream important steps. I will focus on the design part of a project called the B Excavator. So it's an internal Dassault Systèmes project to illustrate the value of the integrated heavy machinery. The goal is for the styling design department to rethink the cabin of this B excavator, to follow some important objectives of the company, to make the cabin smart, safe, connected. And for that, what we will do is to design, keeping always the human at the center of the design thinking, from creative exploration to design to engineering, everything we do has to be around the human, for the design, the shape, for sure, but also for colors, material, HMI, all the elements of the cabin. And we want to do the design, but more than the design, also the human experience, in fact, the operator experience, to simulate while we're doing the design, what will be his personal experience, including the behavior of the human with the object and the cabin. And all that also taking into consideration the safety and the comfort of the cabin. By running several kinds of simulation, we can, while we're doing design, simulate the safety and the comfort and to change the design accordingly. Okay, so as I said, I will not cover everything. I will focus mainly on the early design of the cabin, early creative aspect design of the cabin, from social ideation and collaborative innovation, till the requirement, the official requirement, to the creative design, there's some simulation for the comfort and safety, And system and marketing, we will not cover that today. We will not have time to cover that. But I encourage you to look at all the industry solutions if you're interested in. So first of all, as I said, the Trade Experience Platform provides all the social collaborative tools for the decision makers, but for every collaborator to create kind of dashboards to look at what are the trends on the market, to do surveys, to also do some brainstorming sessions, as you can see on screen right now, with tools to help people to collaborate, bring ideas, but also to create social communities like this one, where anyone in the team can create posts, ideas, to illustrate that, and then to start to brainstorm all together to leverage what we call the social innovation in the company and in the teams. So you have all these inputs coming from the external world by creating dashboard of the trends on the market. So we have solutions to sneak over the web what the competition are doing, what are your customer wishes, what are the market trends, and so on. But also to listen to what the team members are saying, thinking, or suggesting in terms of innovation. And on the other side, you also have the existing 3D product. So for this project, what we want to do is to start from an existing excavator, and we have to redesign the cabin to make it more modern, to integrate some new electronic devices, and to also address more comfort and safety for the operator. So we also have access to this 3D as an input for the project. So what we're doing, first of all, we are starting to put the human, even before starting any creation, we integrate a human, a virtual human, to look at what will be his use case, his usage. So for sure, as the operator is to drive and to manage the excavator, but also to access some elements for work, for his personal usage, but also for safety, or to access some elements, or to enter and exit the cabin, and so on. So as we integrated this human with the different posture, then the creative people start to do the design directly in 3D on the existing engineering data of the previous model to start to sketch in 3D the new ideas of design, starting by the seat design, sketching in 3D the natural language of the creative designer. But as you can see again, keeping the human at the center of the design in posture with different postures of usage. So the creative guy is not doing just a nice looking cabin or elements of the cabin. He's really doing a appealing design, but which is very useful for the user experience. So exploring many ideas in 3D sketch or virtual clay modeling, like you can see here, to do the joystick for the operator. And even at the very early phase, he can already try to simulate and test the usage by the user. And at any time, you can do 3D print to also touch by yourself your design, the shape of your design, if it is ergonomic, useful or not, and to adapt it live. So we are completely breaking the silos between the different departments of design, engineering, ergonomics, and so on. Everybody can work together on the same platform and have this kind of iterative loop of creativity. Here you can see we are doing the joystick design, and at any time we are moving the hand of the human, and the fingers are grabbing automatically the joystick to see if the joystick shape design is useful or not. Then we use also the 3D Experience platform to do the briefing, to do brainstorming session. So directly in 3D, you can do 3D sketch to brainstorm between the team, and also to do that in a virtual reality. To have a better perception of your design, you can immerse yourself into the 3D, and even if you're not an expert of 3D, quickly understand the proportion, the volume, the elements of your design, and see also with some annotation and text the briefing of what the designer wants to do. At any time when you start to do your modeling and your design, you can do design reviews with the virtual reality human. So putting the human, but putting yourself in the eyes of the human and also checking with the arms and hands what will be his experience in terms of access to different elements of the design of the seat, the cabin, the HMI, the displays, the safety buttons, the joystick, and so on. So very, very early in the process, sorry, and very quickly, you can already experience the reality of your design. So here we are doing some adaptation, we are changing some shapes after some iteration with the virtual humans and the ergonomic people and so on. And we will start also to work on the colors and material. So here we are still doing the design of the seat, adapting the shape of the seat. And now we will start to apply some materials. So here I will do some leather or texture versions of the textile version of the seat, with some specific mapping to see if the textile will resist of the deformation, and to apply some color material. And what we are also doing is to present, you know, when you're a designer, you need to present to the decision makers your design. So we also have in our creative design portfolio some tools for presentation, so to present the different design, the different postures, the different versions of design we want to propose. And very easily, you can combine all these proposals with this kind of design, with this kind of button, with this color, in this position. So for all the decision makers, which can be the chief designer, which can be the product managers, or even your focus group customers, to take decisions about what is the best suited design between all your proposals. As I said, when you're doing design in the creative design department, it has also to rely on real engineering behavior, for example, kinematics, assembly, technical parts, technical elements, and so on. So that's why having an integrated solution is very important. And also, again, putting the human simulation and playing the human simulation at the time. Here we are doing motion capture also in virtual the virtual world. So the real operator is moving, and we are capturing in real time, in virtual reality, all his movements that we can replay at any time afterwards to see where he had some clash or some discomfort position and so on. The goal of all that is to be able to very quickly do design change even before producing any physical model. So to save time, energy, cost, and also to make sure that we're doing the right design very quickly and at the first shot. As I said, we were also managing the colors and materials. So at the beginning, you do your 3D modeling, but you can also simulate your color and material behavior. Not for marketing purpose, here we are still in design engineering. So for the passenger, the operator usage and comfort. So what we're doing is physically correct representation to be able to simulate the real world. Not to do a nice looking effect for marketing or movies. We are doing here rendering to take the right design decision in terms of shape, colors, material, but also reflections, behavior of the materials, and so on. So we are putting an environment with the lighting condition. We are putting the materials on the different objects, including the lighting or the display. And we can run physical correct rendering to see how it looks like, but also to analyze some wrong behavior. So for example, during the daylight, we have some elements reflection which can be very bad for the operator. So we decided not to put the yellow emissive panels here, but to lower the intensity to make sure the operator doesn't have this kind of bad reflection on the windshield. Okay, so we are also simulating the virtual twin in terms of rendering with physical representation of lighting, materials, and behavior to make a good design and to make the right design for the operator. Same for the display. So we're doing this, we can do this rendering by day, by night, also on a very specific location on the planet, having the right sunlight at a certain time. So we are able to simulate several kinds of conditions of usage from different point of view. Again, we can put ourselves in the eyes of the operator in different environments. Another thing which is important is also is the perceived quality, which is a big trend also, as you know, very famous in the automotive industry, to bring more value to your product, making sure the perceived quality by your consumer is better. So we can simulate that to improve the perceived quality. So in terms of lighting, for sure, but also in terms of fit and flush and gaps between the object that can create a bad feeling for the operator of quality. So if you can simulate and adapt your design to have a better perceived quality very early in the process, that's much, much better in terms of value for your products. So here we also are rendering and simulating and choosing different materials, positions, lighting, to see all the dispersive quality. As I said, we are doing the cabin design with all these elements. So it's very important to then to see also the combination of all these elements in terms of behavior, but also in terms of combination. What about if I select this kind of design of seats with this kind of material, and how do I perceive it from this point of view, with this lighting, with this display, and with this kind of posture of the human? Again, to brainstorm, to present, and at the end to take the right design decision, or to adapt, change your design. Here, for example, we discovered that this proposal of design to put the safety button at this position was not good for the operator if he has the HMI display in front of him. So it's very important to be able to simulate all that in the virtual twin before producing the model. As I said, safety and comfort is also very important. So the idea here is being on the same platform at any time of your design process to be able to simulate. For example, here we did focus on the HVAC system and the glass behavior, and also the noise, to simulate all that before the production of this cabin, to see if this design in terms of position, in terms of shape and so on, create any kind of discomfort for the operator in terms of noise, in terms of good repartition of the heating or the air conditioning. So the benefits of having this kind of solution totally integrated is to, first of all, to increase your innovation. Because being on the same platform, to be able to iterate between the different tools, from creative design, engineering, system, simulation, human behavior, all that in an integrated world, will allow everyone to do an iteration loop of creativity and at the end to bring more innovation. As I said, it's also enforced the product compliance to regulation, so making sure the design fits with the regulation simulation, and all that for sure to reduce time to market and cost, as you don't have to produce many, many physical prototypes. So I would like to thank you for this time. I hope you saw the value of this integrated heavy machinery solution from Dassault Systèmes. And if you have any questions, please feel free to contact us or to go to our website, tds.com. Thank you.